Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. My name is Don Nascimento, and in today's video tutorial I'm gonna show you the easiest way to select, group and sort data from Excel files. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like it, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a comment and yes, like the video. So let's get started. As you can see, I already have a new workbook open here, and in the right side I have this file called sales data. This is a workbook that contains over 1 million rows, so it's the file we're gonna use to extract the data. And if you want to use this same file, you can just download. I'm gonna put a link on the description down below this video, so feel free to download and use it to replicate the steps I'm gonna show in this video, right? So if you open this workbook, you are gonna see that I have two worksheets. The first one is called Cells, contains the general information about the cells, and the second one contains all the details about each one of the cells. So these the worksheets work together, right? And one very important thing that you have to know whenever you use a SQL language to work with Excel file is that the worksheet names represent the tables and the header names represent the fields. So you have to know that before you type your first SQL comment, right? So let's jump in. I'm gonna minimize this workbook and maximize this other one. And here the first thing you have to do is to select the data tab and locate this button here called existing connection. I don't know which version of the Excel you guys using. I'm using Microsoft 365, so if you use another version, maybe the position of this button may change from one version to another, right? But hope you find this button here. So you just click in here in this button, and in this new window we click here in this button browse for more. And now it's just to locate the file we are gonna use to extract the data. So mine is in this folder here, file here, and let's double click OK, and click here in this the properties button, right? And then in the definition tab, and here in comment type we switch to SQL. And here in the comment type, you just type our SQL comment. So, and what exactly you want to extract here? We want to select the top 10 best sellers, group these sellers, and sort the data based on the purchase amount, right? So we can just put here the selected keywords. So let's type here, select top 10, because we have the top 10, right? Top 10 best. So and the first field we are gonna put here is the seller name, right? Seller name. Don't forget to use the brackets, right? Because we have spaces between the words, so you have to use the brackets, right? Comma, spacing, next line. And here we are gonna put the second field. It's called the purchase amounts. Plus purchase amounts, but here we want to do a sum. So let's type here sum, right, to sum the amount, space, next line, and now we have to informate the from where the data is come from. So the data come from the table cells, right? So here we use the same name as I just told you, the same name of the worksheets, right? So cells, and we have to use this symbol here. I don't know how to say this, the name of this symbol in Portuguese is called cifrão, and in English is cifra, but I don't know if you guys use the same name, but it's a dollar, right? It's a dollar symbol. And if possible, you put in the comment, and you'll be thank you the correct name for this symbol here, right? So every time we work with Excel data, we have to put this symbol right next to the table name, right? So let's close here with the brackets. And space, next line, and now we have to group the data. So let's put here group by, And we have to group it by one of those fields, right? I'm going to select this first one, so group by seller's name, right? Space and the next line. And now we have to sort out data. So you put here order by, and once again, you have to use, we have to select one of those, these two fields here to order the data. And here we are the data based on the second field. So you put here two, and then the order we're gonna use is this, right? Descending, and we use I don't know the name of the symbol, sorry guys, but yeah, I think everything is okay. And now we can just click okay and see the beauty of our queries, right? So just wait a little time. Oh, look here, very beautiful, right? And we can change this name here, right? To do that, you just let's click here in data tab and the query and the connections here, and double click, and let's change here. I'm gonna give a name for this column here, right? This field. To do that, you just type here as keywords and the name you want to use. Here I want to use the name total row, right? And so let's click OK. And now we just wait. Let's zoom, look. So we have finished. And so yeah guys, this is all for today. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and once again, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video. So see you soon in the next video.